Welcome and herzlich willkommen to a new issue of Photomove, my small magazine about culture, art, Europe, food, photography and cookies. But sorry, today I can't start like I did it the whole year before, because this is a live stream and today is the day of the terrorist attack in New Zealand. And I'm really stunned and I'm really shocked about it. 49 people lost their lives during this attack without any reason, without any reason. And for me, it's really shocking, and it reminds me so deep of the terrorist attack in Norway in 2011. But also, it reminds me of Paris and Berlin and London and all those terrorist kinds of happenings. And yes, there is no, I try to understand the creepiest crimes and the creepiest things, and I really try in my life to have different points of view, but this is the limit. This is the limit. Terrorism is really the limit. It's for me, I have no special place in my brain, not even to accept it. There is no place to understand it. So buying a gun and shooting children and people and men and women who have nothing to do with whatever those terrorists have in their creepy, stupid minds. So yes, and a special reason why I want to address this is that there is a small similarity, because the terrorist streamed the attack on Facebook. So he did just around 16 hours ago, he did the same like I do now. I know it's just a technical way, but he want to reach an audience, so for his unbelievable doing. As I said, I do now the same. I want to reach an audience. Normally I just start with some funny stuff or something about culture or photography, as I said. But I can't start today, not so fast. I had to address this because I really hope somebody, you ask, why are you doing this? It's a lot of work. It's in the beginning there were nearly no there were no audience. It's cost me some money. Whatever. And sometimes I lost my way, and I do very sometimes I do cultural things, now I do some food stuff for some issues, but the reason is, and it sounds maybe a bit naive or crazy, I hope such kinds of streams like I do, I hope that Photomove make this crazy world tiny, don't misunderstand me, a tiny bit better, because the internet and such stream is normally such a good way to communicate. And so I'm very sad that today I'm running out of words, such a terrorist, a crazy mind, uses the same way to show his crime against humanity. Okay, I must address this, and so it's now a bit difficult to come to or change the topic to some funny things, but as I said, the funny things and the culture and to talk about this stuff, I hope it makes the world a bit better, and especially it's such a dark day for every real human on the world. It's maybe good to talk about Dutch fish. Yeah, that's I said it. It's a big change. Yes, and today we talk about Dutch fish, especially about Matthias Hering. Matthias Hering, sometimes for somebody it's just gross, but let's see how it is, let's see how it tastes, and let's have a closer look. Herring is a fish, of course, so, but what is Matthias? It's herring too. It's a special kind of herring, and it's a very young, especially very young herring. So there is normally a special season in especially the Netherlands where you can get or buy those kind of young and fresh herrings to eat it. In a kind you eat it raw, so a lot of people think, well, I can't eat raw fish, but okay, a lot of people eat sushi too, but sushi and Matthias is really completely different in taste. I show you the Matthias. It's here right in front of me. Whoops. And as you see, it's a kind of herring, so this typical silver color, but I think you can see it in the video, that it's very tender, so a bit soft. And especially the skin is not so hard, like leather kind. And as you see, if I put the knife on this side, I can even scratch this silver part away. It's very, very soft. So it's fermented in salt, salt mixed with water, but not so much salt. A herring can be very salty, but a Matthias is very mild. And in this water and salt mixture, it ferments, and you can. What's the word for it? It's preserved. It's preserved in this way, especially this. I have to confess, this Matthias is not completely fresh. It was a packed, Matthias, I bought for you or for us this evening. And it's not fresh from the Netherlands. Next time, maybe I bring some fresh food from the Netherlands, because I just live 50 kilometers away. 50 kilometers is with my car, don't know, 30 minutes, about 30 minutes or 35 minutes. And I am in the Netherlands and can buy some fish. And that's a tradition for me. Me and my family visits Venlo. It's a small town nearby, the town direct at the border. And in Venlo there is a real nice marketplace, and there is always a fish market. And there, if we visit Venlo, our first way is buying some Matjes, especially in the season, in the Matjes season, and eat it. And in the Netherlands, you eat it in a small bun, in a very soft bun, a little bit sweet. That's nice. You have this slightly sweet bun, and they put the fish in it and some onions, and you can eat it, or you, I don't do it now, you can put the matjes at the tail. Yeah, well, I don't want to touch it now, because I have to work now here with my test, with my keyboard and so on. But you can put it and eat it directly, so lift it and in your mouth, in your rachen, what's the word for rachen, in your throat, of course, deep, you can deep throat a matjes, so, but I don't do it now, okay. Okay, that's a special experience when I said it, when we visit Venlo. Venlo also is a very nice town, and I will do some shows about Netherlands food or food from Holland, of course. But now I prepare these fish for you. I forgot a fork, but I can take this... I can take this little spoon. I prepare it like I eat it often here. And it's always, you have these both sides of the fish. Let's call it the fillet. In this case, the fish bones are mostly out of the matjes. If you eat it in Venlo, it's the same way, but you can buy herrings or matjes that has a complete bone in it. So then you have to lift it off. So I open it. So it's very soft. It's very soft. I think you can see it. So, and let's lift up this rest, the small piece of fishbone and the tail. So, tender, soft, and juicy. That's the word I'm looking for since I started to talk about it. It's very juicy. So, and I think it looks good, aren't it? So, from both sides. Okay. So, and the special way I eat it is, and I didn't know it before, because I thought it's my invention. It's a style you can eat it in Norway too, with some crunchy bread. You see, this is some not just Norwegian, Sweden, and the northern states of Europe. And there is what they call smørbrød, I think, or brød. Well, good question to my audience there. We call it Knäckebrot. So, Brot, the German word for bread, and Knäckebrot is the sound, this crunchy bread, maybe. And I don't put butter on it, I put some cream cheese on it. So, and it's, you may wonder, but it's horseradish style cream cheese. So, a small layer of it, horseradish. I really like horseradish, to be honest. So, and never forget the onions. Here, some small onions sliced in fine cubes. And I put the onions off the cream cheese so they can't fall down. I'm a clever guy, aren't I? So, and then it's maybe they produce the bread especially for the Matjes because it's really prepared to fit two fillets on it. So now it's a bit juicy and so on because more. Okay, that's it. And let's have a bite. Okay. Ooh, I have some. So just for my fingers, yeah. Okay. That's good. I'm really hungry now. And so, how does it taste? Of course, slightly salty. For sometimes taste or some viewers, maybe a bit too salty. But I can say that if you buy a normal herring or a usual herring, it's much more salty. Much more, maybe more like sardines or like next show. So it's slightly salted, so, and okay, it has this real strong fish taste, a little bit. If you really never tried it, this fish taste is a little bit like soya sauce. A little bit. Like soya sauce. And in combination with the onions, and especially the horseradish, because the horseradish cream cheese is, I don't want to say sweet, but it's a little bit sweet, a little bit sweet, slightly sweet, with these slightly hotness of the horseradish. I really like this. And this goes very well with the fish and the onions. And I like this soft bun style you can buy in the Netherlands. I already told you about it. But everything is soft. The onions are more or less soft. The cream cheese is soft. And the fish is very soft. And so it's nice to have some crunch under it. Okay. I think I I think I must eat it complete because there is no space to for the rest. Yeah. Now I, if I think about it, the fish is not just like soya sauce or salty or very savory. I told you about umami. It's a bit umami, it's also a little bit bitter. Not much, not bitter, but a little bit bitter. So very, very tasty. And these small fish bones, if you saw it, you can see it there on the contrast. they're very soft, so no problem that you yeah, smother, suffocate, or choke. Okay, this was my little issue about fresh fish from the Netherlands. I said it, I will do some more shows about the Netherlands, and now at the end of the show, I want to send some greetings to Ori. Ori will be back, I think, next week, and we will talk about Balkan sweets. That was a topic. Balkan sweets. They are already in my kitchen. And it's difficult to go around these sweets and do not eat it. But we will talk about it next week. He is ill and lost his voice this week. So my from my heart, wishes out to Uri. We will see us soon. And not just Uri and me, you and me will see us soon again. I hope you enjoy this show. I think that you understand my first words at the beginning. It was for me, it was really important to talk about it. Maybe we should talk about more often about such topics. Yeah, if you like it, as always, smash the like button, subscribe to the channel. It's really important for me. And if you don't like something, whatever, please write it down in the comments below. I will read it and I promise to answer. And now have a nice weekend. See you next week and have a good time. Bye-bye.